I hope you appreciate this, Gaffney.
What?
Being given trolley duty.
It's all right, I suppose.
Keeps you out of the laundry for the better part of the day, doesn't it?
So?
I thought you'd be glad to get away from Smith. Still, if you want to go back, I can always arrange it.
What's Mr. Harrison really like, Miss Bennet?
Don't be insolent.
No, it's just that I've been in and out of this dump for years, and it's the first time I've ever met a real live bent screw.
You better mind what you say, Gaffney.
It's true, Miss Bennet. He just took some bets for me. He's going to put them on at the TAB.
Making false accusations against an officer is a criminal offence.
Go ask Loverboy about Fancy Nancy and Paradise Lost in the Third at Kyneton, then.
Yes, what can I do for you?
It's about Mrs. Morris.
Well, Mrs. Morris is sick today. I'll just note your name and record your attendance.
It's Nick Clive.
Oh, you're the one responsible for the suicide hoax.
Yes, sir.
Now, look, Mrs. Morris is here to help you, not to be harassed every time you need a bit of attention.
I'm sorry, Greg.
We're very fortunate that Mrs. Morris gave you a good report. Otherwise, you can be sure this matter would have been investigated by the welfare department.
Won't happen again.
Well, see that it doesn't. All right, I've recorded your name. Here we go.
I came to deliver these reports.
Well, these are confidential. Where did you get them?
From home.
What?
Mrs. Morris is sick, so I brought them in for her.
You said home?
That's right. I'm staying with Mr. and Mrs. Morris.
Are you?
How you going, Lizzie? Ready to start taking bets?
Oh, B, I don't know if I can do this.
Now, what's that supposed to mean?
Well, not everyone can be a book, you know, and I've never done it before. The thought of all that money makes me nervous. Oh,
come on, how long have you been betting?
Well, a good while, I suppose.
Yeah, well, you'll be all right. And besides, everyone knows the bookie never loses.
Ha!
All right, what is wrong with you? You've been walking around looking as sour as Vera all morning.
How do you expect me to look? I don't exactly enjoy getting bashed, you know.
Oh, God, you're not still on about that, are you? Look, I've told you I've got Gaffney under control.
You reckon? She testifies against you in court. She thumps your mates. And the best we can do is not talk to her. Well, big deal. You reckon that's teaching her a lesson?
Listen, you saw the new screw giving her some tobacco, right? Well, if they have got a deal going, we will be able to use her. We can leak false information to the screws whenever we want to.
Yeah, what's that got to do with it?
Oh, wake up, Australia. If Margot is running around covered in bruises, the screws aren't going to believe a word she says, because it'll be obvious we don't trust her. Now, am I going too fast for you?
Of course not. I know what you're talking about.
Well, hallelujah.
Uh-oh. Here's that funny smell again.
Strange how it keeps coming back, eh?
Okay, Lizzie, got yourself sorted out?
Yeah, I reckon it's going to be easier than I thought.
All right, ladies, place your bets. The new bookie is about to go into business.
I've decided not to go by the odds that are in the paper. I'm making my own odds.
Oh. Well, you got sure of yourself real fast.
Yeah, it's like B said, I've been betting a long time. And now that I've picked me a winner, I reckon I'll do it my way. It's going to be dead easy.
Nice, isn't it? Working together on it gives us a chance to see each other during the day. It just makes work more pleasant.
Yes, it does. It's nice having someone to work with who feels the same way I do about the job.
Hmm?
Well, you know what I mean. So many people feel differently about how the job should be done.
What do you mean?
Well, I've met a few officers who seem to think the rules are a big joke.
Well, we've all worked with them. It's an occupational hazard.
Well, I think it's disgusting. The rules are there for a reason. They should never be ignored.
You know, some of the best officers I know bend the rules occasionally. Sometimes the situation warrants it.
But, Terry,
look, Vera, let's not talk about work now, eh? Actually, I've got to get back. Look, I've packed my toothbrush. All right if I move in tonight?
Yes, of course.
Fine. Well, I'll see you later.
Oh, good morning, Meg. Sorry to disturb you, but this is fairly important. How are you feeling?
Oh, terrible, thank you, but come on in.
Thanks.
Sit down.
Thanks very much. Well, I'll get straight to the point. I've just had a most upsetting meeting with Nick Clark. I felt I had to see you as soon as possible.
Nick, but where did you...
This morning he came sailing into your office bringing your reports with him.
My reports? But how did...
Well, that's exactly what I asked him. He said he brought them from home. I'm sure you're aware that nobody outside the office should ever see those papers.
Well, of course I am. But I'm sure Nick meant no harm. He was just trying to help.
Look, his motives are not my concern at the moment. But I was amazed to learn that he's actually living here with you.
Well, it's not a permanent arrangement. He had to get out of the place he was living in. There was nowhere else for him to go.
That is entirely beside the point. Look, there is no reason strong enough for involving yourself that closely with a client. What on earth did you think you were doing?
I was helping him. I mean, that's my job, isn't it?
Surely you've had enough experience with prison work to know that it's emotional suicide to get too involved with any one case?
Well, normally I'd agree with you. But in this case, I was giving help where it was urgently needed. There's no personal feelings involved. I was simply helping someone out.
I'm sure you mean that, but please just think. You have other cases that have problems with accommodation, right? So why this boy in particular?
Well, I only thought...
Look, I'm sure your motives were good, but in this instance, I'm afraid you have no choice. The boy must go.
Oh, but he was
look,
just
I'm sorry, that
to...
is my final word. Now, look, I've no wish to make an official issue of this. That's why I came by myself this morning. But I must stand on departmental policy. Nick must find somewhere else to live immediately.
Down near the bend, and Peppercorn, the leader from Golden Boy and Star Race, is starting to make a race of it. Coming to the turn, 400 to go as they wheel into the straight, and the leader, Peppercorn...
Come on, Peppercorn, you can show him how to do it! Tell him what you're made of, boy!
Straight past Golden Boy and is chasing Peppercorn. Peppercorn's still in front, he won't give in.
I think he'll push it well, is he?
Hard, but it's Peppercorn by a half.
Yeah, hit it!
Well, I'm glad I took your tip. I could use the extra money, huh?
Yeah! And you others better pay up. Looks like you're going to be real good at this, Lizzie.
Yeah, it'll be nice to be able to place a bet when you want to instead of when someone says you should.
Yeah. And now your bank's started to grow, I think maybe you should have some protection, Lizzie. Hey, you two. I got a new job for you. From now on, you are now the official bodyguard of the new bookie. And if anything happens to her or her bank, I'm going to hold you personally responsible. Understood? Well, have you got some sort of problem? Go on. Well, I think it's really official now that you've even got protection, Lizzie.
Yeah!
Now!
Oh, here, I'll take that.
Good. There is more.
Oh, look, I'll get it.
Wait a minute. Say hello to me first.
Hello.
Hi. Well, look, you relax, I'll go and get the rest of the stuff. I didn't realize I had so much.
Oh, Terry, that's no way to treat your uniform. It'll be a mess in the morning.
I just got here and you're nagging already.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Hey, come on, I'm only teasing. I love you looking after me. In fact, you can hang up my uniform, otherwise it'll be a mess in the morning. Yeah, it is a bit of a mess. Well, what are we going to do tonight? Eat out or stay at home? Please say stay at home. I don't think I'm up to going out. Vera? Oh, I can't eat anymore. You know, I must have one of the best landladies in town. Food's one of my biggest vices. That must be one of the best meals I've ever had.
What other vices have you got?
You?
Be serious for a moment. There must be such a lot we don't know about each other.
Ah, you want to know all my dark secrets, huh? All right. I drink, smoke myself stupid, gamble away all my hard-earned cash, and chase around with loose women. You're serious, aren't you? All right, I've cut smoking down to about 10 a day. I have the occasional social drink, the odd bet, but I wouldn't know one end of a horse from the other. Now, what is the matter?
There was a TAB ticket in your jacket. Margot Gaffney said you placed a bet for her. Is it true?
So that's what this is all about. Yeah, I placed a bet for Gaffney, so what?
Oh, Terry, that's trafficking. You know the rules.
Oh, come on, don't be so dramatic. It's no big deal. Anyway, there was a good reason for it.
There can't be any reason for trafficking.
Oh, no, wait just a minute. What about you? You're the one that makes deals with the prisoners that you have no intention of keeping.
That was different.
I needed to prove that Smith was faking her amnesia.
And I want Gaffney on side, so if she's got any information, she'll give it to us. Now, I really don't see there's any difference.
It is different. It's wrong.
You think you should report this? Look, Vera, if we're going to make it, you're going to have to take me the way I am. I mean, it's my neck. I'm willing to take the risk. Now, you're going to have to make up your mind.
All right. But I still don't agree with you.
We can't agree on everything. Otherwise, we'll get bored with each other. Now, look, the rest of the night, let's just concentrate on something other than work. All right?
Darling, you should have stayed in bed.
Oh, that's all right. I was feeling a little better, so I got up.
Hi.
Hi,
how are you feeling?
Oh, a bit better, thanks. There's something I want to discuss with you, Nick.
Sure. What's up?
Did you take some files this morning?
Mm-hmm. What's this?
Oh, it's all right, Bob. I don't think you meant to do anything wrong.
I just took them down to your office for you, Mrs. Morris. I knew how important it was for you to get them to work, and you couldn't do it.
Yes, well, I appreciate that, Nick, but you should have checked with me first.
You mean you took them out of the case, you saw them?
They were on the table. I didn't read them. I was just trying to do someone a favour.
Yes, I know you
were. That's not the point. Now, look, young man, you've got to learn to think before you act, or you're never going to get anywhere.
Oh, forget it.
Bob.
Well, you should have thought. How'd you find out, anyway?
Oh, Mr. Muirhead called in. He was terribly upset. He said Nick will have to move out.
Well, what's it got to do with him?
Well, you know, we're not allowed to get personally involved.
You're supposed to help them, but you're not allowed to get involved. Now, that's a piece of brilliance.
Well, it's departmental policy.
Departmental rubbish. I invited him here, not you.
Oh, Bob, please. Look, I don't like it any more than you do, but it's my job that's at stake.
Yeah, well, it's my house, and I say he stays. I'm not being dictated to by the lights of Muirhead. If he gives you any trouble, refer him to me.
Well, I reckon you did real good, Lizzie.
Of course I did. 3 races out of 7. Of course, I did a lot of form studying, you know. Look, Dor, I'm rolling.
Yeah, well, you won't be rolling for very much longer if you wave it around like that. You never know who's watching.
Oh, there's nobody about except them two, so there's no worries. Hey, you two, stay there and watch the corridor and don't let anyone into this cell.
Hey, just leave a look on their faces.
Yeah, wasn't it for you?
Now, where am I going to hide this? You could always put it under the mattress.
Oh, God, no, everybody does that.
Oh, yeah, you're in the big time now. Suppose you'll be loaded in no time flat.
Yeah.
So, you've got to be smarter than the average mug, eh? I should start thinking like you.
I'll put it in here. Oh, yeah. Now, come on. Give me a hand to move this.
Now, pull back. Hurry up, it's heavy.
Oh, hold it.
Hey, Struth, how are you going to manage that on your own?
Oh, that's just it. I can have either you or B to help me move it.
Yeah, up there for thinking, Lizzie.
Yeah, not just to wear your hat.
Who does Muirhead think he is anyway, handing out edicts like that?
Oh, can't we just drop the subject? I really am fed up with the whole business. Anyway, you were telling me about the Swedish thing. Does that mean you've got to tear off somewhere?
No. Well, not yet anyway, but... A meeting's been set up with a member of the Swedish Trade Commission for tomorrow.
Oh.
Yeah, the Swedish furniture manufacturer is looking for an Australian agent, and my name's been put forward.
Oh, that's wonderful, darling.
Well, it could be. If we get the contract, it could mean quite a bit of money.
I wanted to say goodbye. I'll be off now.
Oh, Lord, what now?
Look, I was only trying to help. I did the wrong thing, and I'm sorry. But I'm not staying where I'm not wanted.
Don't be ridiculous, Nick. One mistake doesn't mean you have to leave, no matter what Muirhead says.
What are you talking about? Muirhead didn't say anything to me about having to leave.
No, but he's not too keen on the idea. But it's my house and I say you stay.
Thanks. But I'll be off anyway.
Nick, is this carry-on over the reports the only reason you're leaving?
It's just as I thought.
What?
Are you going to run out every time the going gets rough?
Oh, darling, I don't think...
Nick, stay out of this. You're a waste of time, Nick. You'll never get anywhere in life. And I'm not interested in helping anyone who hasn't got the guts to stick things out.
That's not true.
No, you could have fooled me.
All right. I'm staying.
Come on, Birdsworth, move along.
Just waiting for my mates, Miss Bennett. Okay, here they are. I like a bit of companionship sometimes.
Morning, Gaffney.
G'day. What's he doing on duty? Why shouldn't he be?
Well, didn't you report him for putting a bed on for me?
You don't think I believe that pack of lies, do you?
It's true. I swear he did place a bed for me.
That's enough, Gaffney. Now get moving.
Oh, I get it. Screws sticking together. And they call us crims. He's bent and you know it.
Shut up.
Aren't you gonna put me on report, Miss Bennett? Are you afraid I might talk too much?
Grand dancer? You gotta be kidding.
Oh, I reckon it's a dead cert.
Gee, dead's right. Dead as a doornail.
Oh, well, I'll go for grand dancer, Lizzie.
What, are you gonna bet on all her tips?
Yeah, why not? I reckon she's real good at her job.
Of course I am. There's nothing to it when you know what you're doing. Grand dancer and Satan's Child, 5 for Jude.
Sounds like a good thing to me.
Oh, give us a go, Lizzie. You haven't made up your mind yet.
I want to make a bet on the 5th.
God, Lizzie, do you think they'll ever find out where that smell's coming from?
No.
Now, look, I know Lizzie's the new book, all right, but I've got as much right to make a bet as anyone else. My money's as good as anyone else's. I said I want to make a bet! Take it, damn you!
Bae, you don't need me, love. You've got your own protection now. Haven't you, girls? I said, hasn't she, girls? You're gonna have to give them orders, love. They're too dumb to think for themselves.
Get her out of here.
You heard her.
I said, get her out of here.
Get your hands off me. Get your...
All the way out.
And while you're out there, you can collect the dirty sheets. I reckon you can still handle that.
G'day. Yeah, take it easy. What's the matter?
What's it to you?
Oh, you got trouble?
Bitches.
You want a friendly ear?
Oh, sure. Since when were screws so friendly?
Mm, fair enough. Do you want to place any bets today?
Oh, yeah. Why not? Grand dancer, $2 on the nose. Yeah,
take it easy, will you? It's not exactly legal, yeah.
There's no one around.
Next time, just be careful.
Sure. See you later.
Yeah. Nick?
Yes, Miss Russell?
There's some money missing from the petty cash. Do you know anything about it?
No. Is there any reason why I shouldn't?
It's common knowledge that you... Well, we all know about you, don't we?
That doesn't mean I took your money.
Look, I've worked here a long time. We've never had trouble like this before, not until you came. Well, who else would have taken it?
Look, lady, I don't know who took your money. I don't know and I don't care, but it wasn't me. Do you think I'd be working here if Mr. Morris wasn't sure I'm straight?
You're one of his wife's pets, aren't you? That's probably why you're here in the first place.
That's enough, Mrs. Russell.
I said
it's enough. Now, you should know better than to listen to malicious gossip. Nick's here because I trust him and because I think he'll do a good job, and that's the only reason, do you understand?
Yes, Mr. Morris.
I suggest you go back to work.
Thanks.
I don't want you to say anything to anybody here about staying with us. Do you understand? Now, the rumor's obviously already about that you want to make charges, and it's causing resentment.
All right.
One more thing, Nick. I won't stand for anyone being falsely accused. But if I ever discover you did take anything, God help you. Go back to work.
Well, you keep this up, you're going to clear me out. I won't have a cent left to bet with.
Yeah,
I reckon it's real good that you're winning, Lizzie, but even if we do follow your tips, I mean, the odds are so low, it's not worth winning.
Oh, never mind. Even if you run out of dough, you can use something else like fags or bickies. Personally, I prefer booze.
Well, I think in future I'm going to do what Doreen does and take your tips. That's the only way to win.
That's because I'm such a good picker. Of course, people who don't place a bet, well, they don't have to worry, do they?
Don't or can't?
Now, I wonder who you two could be talking about.
Don't make no difference to me. Got me own way of placing a bet if I want it. Don't need any of yous.
Oh, Nick, come in.
Hi. I brought you these.
Oh, Nick, they're lovely. Oh, just put those in water, thank you.
It's okay, I'll do it. I thought you were going to take it easy today.
Oh, don't let the clothes fool you. I've only just got up, but I am feeling a little better.
Oh, that's good. Mr. Morris won't be home for a while. He's had a meeting with that Swedish bloke. There. Don't look too good, do they?
Never mind, I'll fix them in a minute.
Don't you mind?
What?
You know, your husband working such long hours. I'd imagine most women wouldn't like it.
Well, I sometimes work longer hours than Bob. I mean, even in the middle of the night, I'm still on the job. Like when people ring me up with suicide threats.
How'd you know I wasn't for real?
To be honest, I wasn't sure it was Bob who called you bluff.
Oh, I should have known. I suppose he was sorry I didn't jump.
Nick, that's a terrible thing to say. Do you think he'd have insisted on your staying here if he disliked you as much as you think?
Well, I guess not. But he doesn't want anyone at work to know that I'm staying here. Is he ashamed of knowing me or something?
Oh, don't be so sensitive. He just doesn't want the staff to think it's favouritism. How do you feel about him?
I don't know. He makes me angry, but I guess he's pretty straight.
Like your father?
Oh, no. He was too busy to have any time for me. He'd never listen to a word I said.
Well, I've got time to listen any time you want to talk.
Thanks.
Oh,
will you watch what you're doing, Lizzie? Hey, what's the matter with you today? You got a face like a half-sucked lemon.
Oh, I can't pick a winner for tomorrow's races. I seem to be losing me touch.
Of course you're not. Something will come to you. Hey, why don't you do what I do? Close your eyes and point.
Hey, Gaffney just followed her favourite screw. Get after them. I want to know everything they get up to.
Where's the winnings?
You must have a crystal ball the way you've been picking up.
Yeah, where's the cash?
All right, take it easy. Look, I'm taking a big risk for you. Now, don't get me wrong. I don't want your money.
Yeah, sure, I know. I've been around long enough to know the score. And don't worry, I'll keep my ear to the ground. As soon as I hear anything worth repeating, you'll be the first to know.
Yeah, well, don't you forget.
Sure.
I was waiting for.
What are you talking about?
You got a minute?
This had better be important, Gaffney. I've got better things to do than to waste my time with you.
Oh, it's not a waste of time, Miss Bennett. This is something you're real interested in.
I doubt it. Just get on with it.
Well, here's me proof about that Harrison creep.
I don't know what you're talking about. And you're not supposed to have money in here. I'll make sure this gets the recreation fund.
Oh, sure, Miss Bennett. Whatever you like. Don't you want to know where it came from?
Where?
It's me winnings from the race. Hand-delivered by a bent screw.
Is it really? You don't expect me to believe you, do you?
But it's true, Miss Bennett. You know it is.
Listen, Gaffney, just because you managed to get your hands on some money doesn't mean that you can frame a good officer with it. It's not that easy.
A good officer? Come, Moffat. You know he's bent. Now, what are you going to do about it?
Just watch what you're saying, Gaffney. or you'll be on report.
Okay. You put me on report. I'll have a lot to tell the governor.
God, you've really got it bad for him, haven't you?
This is beautiful. Vera Bennett with the hots for a bent screw.
That's enough, Gaffney. You're being ridiculous.
Am I? Then why aren't you doing anything about it? He's crooked, and you've got the proof right there in your hands.
Your kind make me sick, Gaffney. I should have expected lies from you.
Oh, that's very good, Vera. But I don't buy it. You know I'm telling the truth. He's doing favours for me, so you can bet he's doing them for the others as well. And, they haven't seen many men in here, so what do you reckon he's getting out of them?
You're disgusting, Gaffney.
And you're a loser, Vera.
I reckon Gaffney's up to something. She's got to be lagging for Harrison. She's playing it too cool, and that's got to be the reason. Lizzie, are you listening to me?
What?
Margot and that screw. I'm talking about Gaffney lagging to Harrison. Where'd you been?
Oh, God, I don't know. I'm losing me touch. I can't pick a horse for tomorrow's race.
Oh, don't worry, love, you'll be all right. But be careful, because if Gaffney is lagging, it's bound to be about the book. Look, what are you doing now?
Well, I've never heard of anyone reading tea leaves from a tea bag, but here it goes. You read this for me.
Oh, don't be stupid, Lizzie. If it was that easy, all the bookies would be out of business.
Oh, go on, B. You've done it before. I need help.
I can see a long ocean voyage and a tall, dark, handsome stranger.
Oh, stop it, B. Don't muck about.
Yeah, well, let's hope for your sake it isn't a short, fair stranger. It doesn't turn out to be Harrison. Oh. All right, I can see a sort of hammer shape. Maybe going to take up carpentry.
Hammer. B. You're a genius. Hammerhead in the last race.
Oh, now, come on. You're not going to bet on anything because of what I say, Lizzie. I tell you, I'm not psychic. I just do it for fun.
B, it's an omen. You don't know your own power. Hammerhead. I can't lose.
Ah, at last. I'm starting to get lonely. Hey, what's the matter?
That.
I take it you got that from Gaffney.
She got it from you, didn't she?
Vera, I thought we had this all out last night.
Look, Terry, I'm just worried.
Look, how did you get it from her in the first place, anyway? What? Heavier? Threatener? Search? What?
Oh, Terry.
I mean, you got a reputation for that, haven't you? From what I've seen of your attitude towards the women, there's a reason for it.
I don't even know why you're bothering with her. She doesn't know anything. None of the other women are having anything to do with her. Oh, look, Terry, I just don't want you to get into any trouble.
I suppose you get a little bit of profit out of that, eh? Oh, Vera, I'm sorry. Vera. Like so, I know you wouldn't, Vera. I'm sorry. I didn't mean it. I was just angry. I know you wouldn't. Come on, shh. Don't cry. You know, you're right. I was taking a chance with Gaffney, but I thought it was worth it. Look, I'll tell you what. I'll have nothing to do with her unless she's got some information, all right? Okay. Come on. I'm sorry. I shouldn't lose my temper like that. I say things I don't mean. That place is coming between us, isn't it? All right, tell you what. From now on, our professional life and our personal life will be separate, all right?
Look, I'll try, but I don't know if I can.
Hey, shh. Come on, I'll help you. Now, don't worry. It's going to be all right. We'll make it. Now, come on, stop crying. Okay?
No worries. This is going to be my day, thanks to B.
B?
Yeah, she read me tea leaves. This is going to be my lucky day.
I told you, off your rocker, I cannot predict a winner.
Ha! Huh. You saw a hammer in the tea leaves, didn't you? Oh. And Hammerhead's in the last race, isn't he?
Listen, that could be a coincidence, you know.
No, it's a sign, I tell you. You can't argue with the supernatural.
Oh, I'm Gaffney, you can move faster than that.
What's the matter with you? Vera give you a hard time last night.
All right, cut it out.
Take it easy, will you? Just wanted a chance to have a word alone with you, that's all. I want to place a bet.
You think I'm an idiot or something? I know you've been reporting to Miss Bennett. You're trying to set me up, aren't you?
I didn't know what else to do, Mr. Harrison. I mean, you don't know what she's like. She forced me into telling. She caught me with the money.
And I was too scared to say anything else.
You expect me to believe that?
Well, it's true.
All right, that's the way you want to play it. You get no more perks out of me until you come up with the goods. And you give me some information, I'll think about it, and I'll get going. Oh, and Gaffney, you try any more tricks like dobbing me in, and you'll be in the pound so fast your head'll spin. You get it?
Yeah.
Right,
sure.
Move.
Oh, come on, Lizzie. You're not still serious about that tea leaf garbage, are you? Of
course I am. As soon as B saw that hammer, everything was as clear as day.
You got rocks in your head, Lizzie.
Yeah, well, the experts don't agree with you. By the looks of things here, they reckon that hammerhead's going to come in last.
Experts? What do they know? I've had a sign, I tell you. All right. Well, don't say I didn't tell you.
Don't call a Dizzy Lizzie for nothing.
Hey, well, I'm offering double the odds on the favourite, but if anyone wants hammerhead, well, I'm not going to give you better than even.
Double? You're crazy.
You just wait till hammerhead romps in, and then you'll be sorry. Now, who's taking bets?
Well, I can't turn that down. What is the favourite? Golden Beauty, isn't it?
Mm.
Don't you think you better ease up, Lizzie?
No, I've got a feeling in me bones.
Oh, first tea leaves, now bones. Well, there's only one way to teach you a lesson. I'll have $4 on Golden Beauty.
All right, what's going on?
Oh, just trying to decide who's going to do trolley duty, Mr. Fletcher.
All right, Hunt, you and Gaffney, the rest of you, get back to work. Come on.
Job's not too bad, I suppose. At least we get a chance to talk away from the others. If you'd listen, it could do you some good. Look, I want to place a bet. I mean, it's not fair, is it? There's nothing wrong with my money, but they won't touch it. You could place it for me.
You've got to be joking.
Look, I can make it worth your while. I've got all kinds of stuff. Pack of cigarettes?
No way, Margot. Forget it.
Makeup, cash, you name it, it's yours.
Bug off.
Listen, I want to make a bet. Now, what are you going to do about it?
Nothing.
What did you say? If I place a bet for you, Bea will be after me. Even if she finds out I talked to you, my life won't be worth living.
You're pathetic.
All right. But don't worry, I'll get someone else to do it. Everyone's got a price.
Nothing you can offer that'd be worth crossing Bea for.
Don't you believe it? There's always something that'll do the trick. All I got to do is find the right bait.
You better be careful. If Bea finds out...
Shut up about Bea. She doesn't scare me. Get lost.
Keep your big trap shut.
Good. They went mad when they heard the odds.
All on the favourite, eh?
Yeah, of course. No one in their right mind would turn down odds like that. Oh. You're going to lose your shirt, Lizzie.
Trouble with you, Jude. You got no faith. That's your problem. No way this little lot's going to leave me.
God, you're a deal, Lizzie. That nag hasn't got a hope in hell.
Did Margot give you any trouble?
Oh, she tried, but I handled her all right.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. But I think you should know, Bea. She disappeared down the corridor for a while.
Really? Where was this?
Down near Judy and Doreen's.
Oh, I wonder what she's up to.
Bloody thing, the batteries have gone flat.
Well, you should have left it off until the race.
Oh, how am I going to listen to the race if it's gone flat?
Don't worry, honey. Look, I'll go and get my radio at lunchtime.
Oh, good on you, Jude. I have to listen to Hammerhead romping.
You mean crawling.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hello. Oh, Terry, what was that you said about keeping your private life separate from work?
Well, hello, kiss is not going to hurt, is it?
Well, someone might come in.
All right. I can't help it. I'm weak.
I'm glad.
Oh, one bit of information will make you happy. Gaffney asked me to place a bet for her. I refused. She'll have to come up with some worthwhile information before I'll help her.
If you ask me, that's a lost cause. The women are really giving her the treatment. From what I've seen, she'll have no information for you at all.
Yeah, I'd like to keep her interest in the proposition.
Well, I'm always arriving too late. Just who was propositioning who?
Oh, like coffee?
Ah, no, thanks, Vera. Now, we're talking about cultivating prisoners for information.
Well, it's happened before.
Yeah, but more on the line of doing them little favours now and again, you know, to keep them on side.
Mm. I suppose Vera disagrees, eh?
Yes, I do.
Well, as long as it doesn't go too far. I see nothing wrong with bending the rules a little bit. Not if it gives you a chance to find out what the women are up to.
Of course you'd say that. What else could you say after what you did? Unless, of course, you're going to tell me that was for the sake of the prison.
What was that all about?
Oh, I managed to recover some stolen money by chatting up a prisoner a while back. Vera's convinced I did it for the reward money.
Oh, I see.
Look, mate,
I know it's none of my business, but really, you and Vera...
Hmm?
I mean, how can you, mate? She's so hard.
Well, that's what I thought at first, but she's not like that at all, Jim. Now, you've got to get to know her. She's not like that at all. I mean, especially away from this place. She's warm. Well, anyway, I like her a lot.
Well, to each his own, I suppose.
Matter of fact, I've moved in with her.
What?
You're kidding?
No, I'm not kidding.
Well, I better get going. I'll see you later.
Well, best of luck.
Hang on, Ben. Give me a hand a minute, will you?
Sure, what is it?
Help me move that. Tip it up. I want to add this to the rest of it.
Listen, Lizzie, don't you think it'd take a bit easy on all those bets? Because if the favourite wins, you're going to be in a dreadful mess.
Well, it's not going to win, is it?
Well, how many times have I tell you, I'm not a fortune teller. I read a book once. I just do it for fun.
I know what I'm doing. I've had a sign, and anyone who ignores a sign has to be stupid.
Anyone who follows what the tea leaves say has to be stupid.
Hammerhead has about as much hope as a snowball in hell.
It's gone.
What?
My radio cassette. Someone's nicked it.
Oh, how are we going to listen to races?
Don't worry. I think I know where it is.
Where?
Well, Phyllis said our little friend Margot went missing when she was on trolley duty this morning.
Oh, Margot, that figures.
Come on, girls, let's get it.
Well, 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 what's going on, ladies?
Oh, nothing, Mr. Harrison.
Good. Well, off you go, into lunch. Otherwise, it'll be over by the time we get there.
I hope it is. Have you tasted it lately? I didn't think it was possible, but it's getting worse.
Pete?
Hey!
Lizzie, keep knitting. Okay, where is it?
What are you talking about? Don't play stupid, the radio.
Come on, Gaffney. You know what we're talking about. Now, are you going to tell us where it is, or do you want to get hurt?
I don't know what you're talking about, I swear.
Phyllis said you left her for a while this morning. Now, where did you go?
I went to the Dunny.
Hey, screws.
Okay, look, grab that one. In the meantime, you better find the other one.
Oh!
Come on, let's get out of here.
What happened?
Oh, I've been spring cleaning. What do you reckon?
What's going on? I don't know. She's playing the usual game, but I think she's been heavier by that quartet I saw in the corridor.
Is that true, Gaffney? All right, suit yourself. Get this mess cleaned up.
Well, there doesn't seem much point in cultivating her anymore, does it?
Was she the one you're talking about this morning?
Yeah.
No, it's a pity. I was hoping she might have been of some use with this project Mrs. Davidson's got in mind, but if the women hate her that much, she's going to be of no use at all. Yeah. In fact, we'd better keep an eye on her.
I'm not feeling very well.
What's the matter?
I don't know. I just got a real bad headache.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, Margot. Must be the food.
All right, Gaffney, report sick. The rest of you keep moving. Come on. Not you, Smith. I want a word with you.
Yeah?
Gaffney seems to have had a bit of trouble.
What sort of trouble?
Somebody tore her cell apart. I don't suppose you know anything about that.
Me? I don't know what you're talking about.
All right, Smith, just remember, it's not a good idea to take things into your own hands.
Jude, do you know what he's talking about?
Oh, I wouldn't have a clue.
All right, just get outside.
You open the gate and I'll go as far as I can.
Oh, I think he means for exercise.
So do I. If he opens the gate, I'll break the 3-minute mile.
Oh, I
That thing was expensive. I want it back.
Take it easy, will you, Jude? You'll get it back. And soon.
Well, how?
Oh.
If Margot has it, it's not in her cell because we ripped the bloody place apart looking for it.
Yeah, but I'm still sure it was her, Jude. And don't worry, we'll find out where she stashed it.
That's easier said than done.
Doreen's right. Listen, this is the first time in our lives we've all been on the one side. No one wants to see Margot get away with anything. If we all keep an eye on her, there's no way she can keep it hidden for long.
That's right, Jude.
Come on, you lot. Listen and weep while I take all your money.
Yeah.
Well, into the straight, we'll back in the field, Lightning and then Misty Lantern, and Breaker's Sun is last. And its Golden Beauty still leading on the inside, followed by Mark III, then Dashing Boy and Trapper's Choice, a gap farther back to Lightning.
Some tip.
Misty Lantern well back with Breaker's Sun. Mark III putting in a challenge on the outside is after Golden Beauty.
Yeah, come on, Golden Beauty.
Well, where's the famous hammerhead? The
last, outside, where do you Mark think?
Won't make it, and Golden
We're listening to the footy, Vera. Collingwood just kicked the goal.
Since when have you all been interested in football? Now the exercise period's over. Get inside. Could you turn that radio off, Birdsworth?
Yes, Miss Bennett.
I've had a vision.
Yeah, I can't lose either. It's an omen.
You're a bloody lovely lot. Laughing at somebody's bad luck.
I warned you not to go relying on any old tea leaves.
That's right, we all did.
When are you going to pay up, Lizzie? Can't wait to have my hands on all that lovely money.
Mm. Neither can I. Margot never gave odds like that. You're going to be a very popular bookie, Lizzie.
Yeah, popular but poor.
Yeah.
It sounds like everyone's anxious to get their hands on the money. Do you want me to help you get it, Lizzie?
Yeah, we'll all help you.
Never you mind. I've got it hidden. None of you gonna know where.
How come Bea knows where it is then?
Because she's such a sterling character.
Never you mind. Why? You'll get your money as soon as I can get to where it is.
Well, I can't wait.
Oh, don't worry, Lizzie. I don't reckon you'll go following the tea leaves again. You just go with your own feelings. You'll get it all back.
Bea. I've got problems.
Yeah, who wouldn't have after losing all that money?
I've worked out how much money I got. B, I took too many bets. I can't pay off.
Lizzie!
B, what am I gonna do?
Hey, Mr. Harrison?
Yeah, what is it, Gaffney?
Well, come in. I don't want to yell it all over the prison, do I?
Yeah, what do you want?
Well, I've been thinking about what you said, you know, about getting some information for you.
Oh, yeah?
Well, I think I've got some.
Uh-huh. What have you got?
Look, Mr. Harrison, I don't mind this little lurk of ours. I mean, it could be good for both of us. But I'm not giving anything away for free. It'll cost you.
Yeah, no way, Gaffney. You owe me.
Suit yourself. Mm. Hey, look, I'm not after $1 million. Just a, you know, a bottle of scotch. And this little lot's worth a lot more than that.
Bottle of scotch, eh? How do I know your information's worth it?
Use your head. You saw what those bitches did to me earlier? Well, I've had enough, and I'm ready to blow the whistle on the lot of them.
Oh, yeah?
Look, you're dead in here if you don't have any friends. I need that grog to buy some support. This was your idea, you know, Mr. Harrison.
All right, I'll get you scotch. Now, what's the information?
That's not the way payoffs work, mate.
All right, I'll get it in for you tomorrow.
And that's when I'll come up with my end of the deal.
You don't trust anybody, do you?
Sometimes it's better not to.
Trust anyone, do you?
Sometimes it's better not to.